Hello everyone, I am going to explain question number 6th from exercise 4.1, and this question belongs from 11th class maths. Here one mathematical statement is given to us and we have to prove this mathematical statement with the help of principle of mathematical induction for all n belongs to capital N, and here capital N's meaning means set of natural numbers. Set of natural numbers means all positive numbers. So first principle of mathematical induction. Mainly this principle have three steps, students. So three steps I am writing briefly in your rough column. So the first step is we have to assume the given statement as Pn. Then we have to prove that for n equal to 1 the Pn is true. And the second step is for n equal to k we have to assume let Pk statement is true. So this is our assumption, so we will write here let. The third step is we have to prove Pk plus 1 is true when Pk is true. So mainly this principle carries these three steps. So by keeping these three steps in our mind, we have to solve it one by one. So what is the first step here? We are going to assume the statement as Pn. So we will write here the statement Pn is defined as, so we have to take this statement as Pn. So Pn statement is 1 multiplied by 2 plus 2 multiplied by 3 plus 3 multiplied by 4, and it's extended up to n multiplied by n plus 1, and it's sum of this series is n bracket n plus 1 then bracket n plus 2 divided by 3 then bracket close. So this is our Pn statement. Now in first step what we have to do, for n equal to 1 the statement is true, we have to prove. So in the Pn statement, wherever n is there, 1 by 1 in left hand side as well as in right hand side, instead of n we are going to replace 1. So this will give us, so condition first, condition first we will write down on substituting . So students, here something went wrong. I am writing here again. On substituting n equal to 1 in left hand side of Pn, we get, so left hand side of, so n equal to 1. So here also instead of n what will come, 1, so it's going to be p1. Now students, since Pn statement is 1.2 plus 2.3, so its meaning is if we have n terms then all the terms we have to take, and if n equal to 1 then you have to take only the first term of from the series, and if you have n equal to 2 then you have to take first two terms, like this it will continue. So since we have here 1 means we have to take only the first term from left hand side of the series. So that will give us, so if we take the first term then we will get only 1 multiplied by 2, that is 2. So this is our left hand side. Now similarly from right hand side of Pn we get, that is a right hand side of P1, because instead of n what we have to replace 1. So in right hand side you have this complete is your right hand side. So instead of and, we have to write down 1. So here also 1, here also 1, and here also 1. So when we replace its value, it's going to be 1 multiplied by 1 plus 1, then multiplied by 1 plus 2, and whole divided by 3. So when we solve it, we'll get 1 multiplied by 1 plus 1 is 2, multiplied by 1 plus 2 is 3, and divided by 3. So this 3 will cut by 3, and we'll get only 2 answer. So we can observe that left hand side of P1 statement is same with right hand side of P1 statement. So we can say that thus for n equal to 1, PN statement is true. Now, so first condition is satisfied because PN came true for n equal to 1. Now we move to the condition second. In condition second, we have to assume the given statement as PK, means we have to take that the given mathematical statement is true for n equal to k. So we write here let for n equal to k PN statement is let for n equal to k statement PN is true, and what is k here that we have to define, where k is any positive integer. So first we will write down what is our PN statement, then we will convert that PN statement for n equal to k. So this is our assumption. So from the question we will write down the PN statement. It is 1 multiplied by 2 plus 2 multiplied by 3 plus 3 multiplied by 4, and it's extended up to n multiplied by n plus 1, and sum of this complete series according to question it's given to us, n, then n plus 1, n plus 2, all are in multiplication, and divided by 3. So this is for PN statement. So if you are assuming that for n equal to k this statement is true, then instead of n we have to replace k value, then pk statement is going to be 1.2 plus 2.3 plus 3.4 plus k dot k plus 1 equal to, now wherever n is there here in the right hand side, wherever you have n there also replace k, so you will get here k, then k plus 1, k plus 2 divided by 3, and big bracket close. Assume this equation as 1. Now this is our condition second, students. Now in condition second you not have to prove anything, this is our assumption only, and now we, with the help of this pk statement, we have to prove condition third. So we write here condition third. In condition third, we have to prove p k plus 1 is true whenever p k is true. So we write here, now we have to prove p k plus 1 is true whenever p k is true. So we'll first form equation, because from pk we need only the first equation, so we'll write down here from equation 1 we have, so write down equation 1, don't write down this pk, only write down this equation, that is 1 multiplied by 2 plus 2 multiplied by 3 plus 3 multiplied by 4, and it's extended up to k multiplied by k plus 1 equal to k bracket k plus 1, then bracket k plus 2 divided by 3, then big bracket close. So now here students, we have to generalize that what term we are going to add in both the sides so that this statement converts to pk plus 1 statement. For that uses we have to observe here, when we have here k, that time the last term is k multiplied by k plus 1, and when we have here n, that time the last term is n, then n plus 1. So in the same way, if we have p k plus 1, then the last term is going to be here. Here the last term is going to be k plus 1 and multiplied by k plus 1 plus 1. Now see here, n, that term n, and then n plus 1. So here you have k plus 1. So k plus 1, then k plus 1 plus 1. Like this we have to do. So finally, this term we have to add in both the sides of this equation. So we'll write here on adding k plus 1 and k plus 1 plus 1 in both sides of above equation we get. So students, I hope it's clear that why I wrote k plus 1 and k plus 1 plus 1, because we had generalized that what is going to be the last term, because we have to convert this equation to p k plus 1, that's why. So we'll erase this what I wrote here extra. Now we'll start it again. We have to add it. So in this equation, in the left side also we'll add this, and in the right side also we'll add this. So that will give us, so it's going to be 1.2 plus 2.3 plus 3.4 plus it's extended up to k dot k plus 1. Then this term we have to add, so it's going to be k plus 1, and k plus 1 plus 1 is equal to big bracket, this right hand side I am writing as it is, that is k, then k plus 1, k plus 2 whole divided by 3, and we are going to add here k plus 1, I don't have space, so I am just writing here, that is k plus 2, because 1 plus 1 is 2. Now this side, you can see that this left hand side is converted to statement p k plus 1. So in next step we have to write it as, so this is converted to p k plus 1 statement. So we can write it as 1.2, then 2.3, and it's extended up to, so this term we can avoid, we can directly move to the last term, that is k plus 1, and here students, k plus 1 plus 1 is going to be k plus 2. Now here I am to take the LCM. So when we take the LCM here, LCM is going to be 3, and this side will come as it is, that is k, then bracket k plus 1, bracket k plus 2, and since I took the LCM, so it's going to be 3 k plus 1, then k plus 2. Now here you can see this k plus 1 and k plus 2 bracket is common in both the terms. So just take k plus 1 and k plus 2 common. So here you are remained with k, and from here you are remained with 3, and it's divided by 3. Now this term we can write as whole divided by 3. So this k plus 1 as it is, and change to the big bracket, this 2 we are going to write as k plus 1 plus 1, because we need to convert the equation like this, that's why. So k plus 2, then sorry, k plus 1. So we erase this. It's going to be k plus 1, then plus 2, big bracket close, like this. Now, why I change this? Because students, you can see in the question, when we have Pn, that time the right hand side was n, n plus 1, then n plus 2 divided by 3. So, if we have Pk plus 1, that time it's going to be here k plus 1. So, just see we have here k plus 1, and here n plus 1 means k plus 1 and then again plus 1. So k plus 1 plus 1 means here wherever n is there, instead of n we need k plus 1. That's why after LCM and after common, whatever we obtained, I converted the answer in this format so that we can directly compare that it's in the form of n plus 1 and n plus 2. So since pk plus 1's right hand side successfully came in the form of Pn's right hand side, so this pk plus 1 statement is true. We can say like this. So it's going to be in next step. So finally we'll write it as thus P k plus 1 statement is true. Whenever P k is true. Hence, by principle of mathematical induction, statement Pn is true for all n belongs to set of natural numbers. So this question is completed, student. I hope this question is clear to you. So mainly we have three steps. You have to prove in first step that the statement is true for n equal to 1. And in second step, you have to assume the statement is true for n equal to k. And with the help of pk statement, in third step, we have to bring pk plus 1 is true. And while proving pk statement, the right pk plus 1 statement, the right hand side is very important. The right hand side you have to convert in the format of right hand side of initial statement which is given in your question, and then just write down that through principle of mathematical induction the statement is true for all the natural values. So I hope this question is clear to you. Further, if you have any doubt, you can write in comment so that I can clear out your doubts. Thank you.